Professor Levinson, Judge Jackson was confirmed three times by the Judiciary Committee and the full U.S. Senate leading up to these confirmation hearings. Republicans, including Lindsey Graham from South Carolina, voted for her on those occasions. But this time around, Judge Jackson, on her way to becoming the first black woman on the high court, faced aggressive, some say hostile, questioning from Republicans. It's not clear if she'll get any Republican votes. What changed?
Well, I think what changed is that the stakes changed and the number of people watching these confirmation hearings changed. And so people like Lindsey Graham have said, well, it's a different ballgame when it comes to the Supreme Court. And there's some truth to that. You and I don't talk about Court of Appeals judges, but we do talk about the Supreme Court. Having said that, if you really look at her record, all that changed is we have some very thoughtful opinions from her when she was a DC Court of Appeals judge about the scope of executive power, specifically executive privilege. And we got to hear even more from her and how she performs as an appellate judge. And frankly, I think that was quite impressive. So there's nothing that happened here in her resume, in her experience, that changed other than, frankly, to bolster her experience for this next task.
Republicans tried to portray Judge Jackson as soft on crime. One Republican called her anti-incarceration and anti-police. Senator Josh Hawley alleged that she had a record of letting child pornographers off the hook when it comes to sentencing. Is Judge Jackson soft on crime?
No, I wish there was a more nuanced answer to that, but the answer is just no. And I wish that these confirmation hearings, look, they've always been a show. They've always been a bit of a circus, but parts of this were just a horror show. So when you look at this line of questioning, why are we having this line of questioning? On the one hand, I think we have the first former federal public defender who will become a Supreme Court justice. So some of these questions are to be expected. I think some of them, frankly, we have to ask ourselves whether somebody who's a different gender and a different race would also get similar questions. But this is a theory that has just been debunked by people on the left, on the right, in the middle. Now, we can assess the sentences that she's given to criminal defendants and look and see that she's not outside the bounds of what many, many federal judges are doing. But particularly when it comes to this idea that she's soft on child pornography, there really is no there. And I think that this is just an attempt to say the words child pornography and Judge Jackson as often as possible.
Republicans would say, look, Democrats were just as aggressive in their questioning with Amy Comey Barrett and Brett Kavanaugh when they were nominated by then President Trump and came before the committee. Are they wrong?
I think they are wrong because there's a difference between being aggressive in your questioning, which is absolutely appropriate when you think about the Senate's constitutional role here, which is to provide advice and consent. Everybody who's going to be a Supreme Court justice should be able to withstand vigorous questioning. That's different from, here's a conspiracy theory, respond to it. That's different from constantly interrupting her. It's different from asking the same question with no basis over and over, hoping that if it's repeated, then somehow it becomes true.
How much of this is about Republicans setting up talking points for the midterm elections? That's one thing that we read and heard about from the political pundit class in Washington this week.
I think a lot of this is about Republicans setting up talking points for the midterms. And I think a lot of this is about Republican senators who are posturing for their presidential runs. We heard from Senator Hawley. I think he's going to run for president. We heard from Senator Ted Cruz. I think he's going to run for president. So we saw, in a weird way, campaign announcements. So yes, it's about the midterms, but it's also about 2024.
This process used to be overwhelmingly bipartisan. That has changed now to the extremely partisan process we now see. I think most people would agree that nominees to the Supreme Court should face scrutiny, but has it become too political? And assuming Judge Jackson comes before a vote in the full Senate, do you have a prediction on whether she'll get any Republican votes at all?
So has it become too political? It's always been a political process in the sense that the President of the United States nominates somebody and then the senators confirm that person. So that's inherently political. But I think what's happened now is that it's just broken down so dramatically on partisan lines. So Judge Jackson would be replacing her former boss, Justice Breyer. He was overwhelmingly supported. Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, overwhelmingly supported. We're not going to see those 90, 87 numbers again when it comes to confirmations. And that's a shame, because the question isn't, do you agree with this person's ideology? It's, are they qualified for the job? What's my prediction here? I think that she will be confirmed by before the Easter break. And I think the real question will be, are we going to hear from Vice President Harris having to cast that tie-breaking vote?
All right, Professor Levinson, we'll all be watching. Thanks very much.
Thank you.